Hallo und willkommen zum 48. Video von 3 Minuten Deutsch. Today we will be continuing with the tenses. Today I'm talking about the third past tense, which is called the past perfect or pluperfekt. Auf Deutsch we say die dritte Vergangenheit or plusquamperfekt. This tense is used when something has already happened, but there are other events that have happened after the first event. In order to use this tense, you use part of the present perfect tense and part of the simple past. You conjugate haben and sein like you would in the simple past, and you also use a past participle like you would in the present perfect tense. In order to show you exactly when something happens in a timeline, I'll show you first the example in the present tense, then in the simple past, the present perfect tense, and the pluperfekt. Wir haben eine Katze. We have a cat. Wir hatten eine Katze. We had a cat. Wir haben eine Katze gehabt. We had a cat. Wir hatten eine Katze gehabt. We had had a cat. Die Kinder sind in der Schule. The children are in the school. Die Kinder waren in der Schule. The children were in the school. Die Kinder sind in der Schule gewesen. The children were in the school. Die Kinder waren in der Schule gewesen. The children had been in the school. Ich esse gerade Abendessen. I am currently eating dinner. Ich aß Abendessen. I ate dinner. Ich habe Abendessen gegessen. I ate dinner. Ich hatte gerade Abendessen gegessen. I had just eaten dinner. Er reist nach Deutschland. He is traveling to Germany. Er reiste nach Deutschland. He traveled to Germany. Er ist nach Deutschland gereist. He traveled to Germany. Er war schon nach Deutschland gereist. He had already traveled to Germany. In order to use this tense, you need to think about whether the verb uses haben or sein in the present perfect tense, and if it's regular or irregular in the present perfect tense. Then you have to be able to conjugate haben and sein in the simple past tense. Often when this tense is used, you can also use a subordinate clause. Although I've not yet made a video about this, it's not terribly difficult to understand what you have to do. If the subordinate clause is after the main clause, you have to move the conjugated verb in the subordinate clause to the end of the sentence. Ich war schon nach Deutschland gereist, als ich in der Schule war. I had already traveled to Germany when I was in school. If the subordinate clause is in front of the main clause, you have to move the conjugated verb from both halves to the middle of the sentence next to the comma. Als ich in der Schule war, war ich schon nach Deutschland gereist. When I was in school, I had already traveled to Germany. If you don't understand how to use main clauses and subordinate clauses yet, don't worry about it. As I said, I'll make a video about this later. As always, there is more information on my blog over here. If you want to see more videos like this, you can always subscribe to this channel. If you want to support this channel, you can find a link to my Patreon page over here. There you can download the scripts to these videos, as well as the worksheets and other resources. Das ist alles für heute. Danke fürs Zuschauen. Bis zum nächsten Mal. Tschüss!